Do you know that longest words are exist on the English dictionary? On this video, I'll share some of this.
Honorificabilitude initatibus. This 27-character word is found in Act 5, Scene 1 of a Shakespeare play entitled Love's Labour's Lost. The word translates to honorableness or invincible glorious. Flux and osinial epilification. This word is 30 characters long. Despite its use of fluxi, the plural of fluxus and which means tufts of woolly hair or small, rounded tufts of clouds, the whole word is not a scientific term. Flux and osinial epilification means trifling, of little or no value or something that has been estimated to be valueless. Hepatic cholangiocolcyst enterostomies. This is a surgical term. The Gould's Medical Dictionary defines hepatic cholangiocolcyst enterostomy as the creation of a link or bridge between a hepatic duct and the gallbladder and between the gallbladder and the intestine to allow these organs to communicate. It is the longest word found in this medical dictionary. Newman ultramicroscopic xylic volcanoconiosis. The word is a name for a type of lung disease. It's the disease suffered by the African miners when they inhale silicon silvers. It is the same as coal miners' disease that is caused by the particles of silicious volcanic dust they inhale into their lungs. Antiperket amtonipar circumvoluti rectum gustpips. This is the title of a book written by Francis Ray Blyce, a 15th-century French Renaissance humanist, doctor, monk and writer. The book described the work of a giant named Gargantua and his son, Pantagruel. Osteokinesanguinea viscercartilaginei nervomedullary. The word is a scientific term related to anatomy. It is one of the words coined by author Thomas Love Peacock and used in his first novel, Headlong Hall, published in 1816. It is actually a compound word created by combining together classic Greek and Latin terms for parts of the body. Equiosilinocalcalinoceratioaluminoscupriovitriolic. This very long word with 51 characters was created by 18th-century English medical writer, Dr. Edward Strother. He coined the word to describe the spa waters in Bath, a city in England.
That's all, folks. Do not forget to subscribe.